Today we will be testing the noise level of both the Generac IQ2000, which is Generac's new portable flagship model, and the Honda EU2000i, which was Honda's flagship model portable generator. Both feature a inverter-style generator, which is boasting quieter noise levels and more stable output for sensitive electronics. We're going to start today by just seeing a sound comparison with both generators under no load and then under the load of a space heater. So let's go ahead and start the Generac first. Now the Generac has a turbo, standard, and economy mode. So first we have to start the Generac under turbo. Once it's warmed up, you can switch it to economy. Standard. And economy. We'll let that stabilize just a little bit. And I am going to get my entirely unscientific decibel meter on my iPhone. Seven at the unit, and we'll get about 7 feet away, which is at the camera, and we're at 70, when I shut my mouth, we're at about 77, 76, and then I get a phone call, as usual. Not too shabby, it's pretty quiet, considering that the iPhone is not the ideal measurement unit or device. So let's shut the Generac off and let's switch over to the Honda. Now for purposes of the test, I will have to state that the Honda unit is used. It's my friend Robert's here, and can't guarantee, you know, this one's fresh out of the box. This one's used, so there might be a slight difference in performance. As well as the Honda's probably broken in at this point, where this one, like I said, I just started this one this morning. The Honda stabilized a little quicker. Eco throttle is on. So now we are at economy mode for the Honda. To 93 decibel at the unit. About 75 at the camera. So it seems like it's a little quieter further away than the Generac was. It also could have something to do with the position of the vehicle. So now let's see noise levels with a load. We're going to plug in a space heater. Start with the Honda since it's already running. Honda struggled just a little bit. Decibel at the unit. 86 at the camera. Still not too shabby, considering we're at about a 1500 watt load. Both units are rated the same, 2000 watt max, which is a burst starting load, and about 1600 watts sustained. Let's switch over to the Generac. Talking. So I guess the Generac does appear to be a bit quieter than the Honda. And one nice additional feature is that the Generac will also tell you what your runtime is at the given load, which also adjusts depending on how much load you are putting on the generator. So lighter load, longer runtime, and the unit displays that. So let's switch down just to show here. And you can see the Generac dropped its load, stabilizing. And it's actually not telling us anything right now. We must have confused it. Fair enough. Well, it does seem the Generac is a few decibel quieter. And let me shut this off. One thing I will also note is what you guys are hearing on the camera is not completely reflective as of what we're hearing out here. I did some previous tests at home with the Generac on the camera, and the Generac did sound considerably louder on the camera due to its much more sensitive microphone than it does in person. They're actually both these units are very quiet, which is extremely impressive. Now, the Generac has, I believe, and I'm going to have to double check on this, I believe it was a 72cc engine, which is smaller than Honda's. Let's get this right here. Of course, it doesn't tell me no. Well, I'll have to look it up. I believe the Generac was a 72cc engine, and I believe the Honda EU was a 96cc engine, so we got a smaller engine on the Generac. But on top of that, Generac does have a higher RPM at full load, which is how it makes up for having a smaller engine, which is all right. It was designed for that, but that also yields greater fuel economy at low power levels. So far, I would say even though the Generac was slightly quieter, I would actually give it a draw between both generators for in terms of noise level. Due to it being such a minor difference, it's almost impossible for the human ear or the average human ear to determine the difference in it. Now, one thing that the Honda has that the Generac doesn't have is DC out. You can plug in a additional cable into the Honda and charge up a 12-volt battery directly. The Generac does not have that in this generation of generators. The previous version of this Generac generator did. Both are also capable of parallel operation, meaning you can connect up two identical generators together to double the generation output. Now the Generac generator also has a fuel gauge, runtime meter, which means remaining power, remaining runtime on that fuel, and a hour meter telling you how many hours are on the unit, as well as a load meter, whereas the Honda just doesn't. Next test, Which one will charge a Model S?
Smile, cheese.